Hello friends, my name is Taufik and you're watching my channel Graphics 10. So today in this video we are going to see the disintegration effect, or some people call it as dispersion effect. So I have selected one image, and now I'm going to select the person in this image, Emma Roberts in this case. You can use any selection tool that you feel comfortable with. So I'm going to be as accurate as possible and as quick as possible. There is always room for improvement and room for precision, but I'm not going to spend too much of time selecting it. So I have selected this particular person, and now I'm going to copy it basically. So Control C and Control V, or Command C Command V if you are using Mac. So Control C and Control V, so that will create a copy of this selection. Then I'm going to delete the background layer, and I'm going to create another layer of this same layer. So I'm duplicating basically. So Control J or Command J, so this creates another copy of this layer. And I'm going to create a new layer by using the layer panel, and I'm placing it under the or placing it at the bottom of all the layers, and I'm going to color it. I am going to color it with white color, but you can choose any color you want, but for now I'm using white color. Now I'm going to apply. First of all, I'm going to move the middle layer towards right, and I'm going to stretch it a bit. But remember to press and hold the shift key, otherwise it will increase proportionally. We don't want that, we only want to stretch it. So press and hold the shift button, and this is to Photoshop version 2019 and above. If you press and hold shift key, then it won't be it won't increase proportionally. So it's exactly reverse in the older versions. So I'm using Photoshop 2022, press and hold shift button and stretch it a little bit, not much but a little bit, and place it over. You can change it afterwards, so it's not that big of an issue. So I'm placing it over here. Now I'm going to apply layer mask to both the layers. So click on the layer mask button, again click on the top layer, and again click on the layer mask button. So we have created layer masks for both the layers. And you remember, in layer mask, if you apply black color, then the layer will hide, and you apply white color, then the layer will be visible. So I'm going to apply black color to the entire thumbnail or to the entire layer mask, so this layer will be hidden. So I'm clicking on this thing, paint bucket tool. You can again, you can simply draw it by using the brush tool, but it will take long. So I'm simply using the paint bucket tool, and remember to select the thumbnail. Don't select the picture thumbnail, but select the thumbnail of layer mask. So this is the thumbnail of layer mask, and choose black color and click on this layer. So black color is applied, that's why it is hidden. Now I'm going to click on the layer mask of the top layer, and now I'm going to select the brush tool. So we are basically we are going to create an effect that the pixels of this image are basically disintegrating from this image. So pixels are square, so I'm going to select a square brush. If you don't have a square brush, then you can simply create by making a selection, simply making a selection and apply black color to that. Black square. Pressing undo. So this has created a brush. So if you don't have a brush tool, then there is no need to worry, we can simply create a brush tool, new square brush. So I have created a new square brush. Now go to the brush settings. This is also present in the window menu, brush settings, or you can simply press F5 function key. Now I want to scatter the brush because I want that realistic disintegration effect of pixels. So scattering, and I'll also change the spacing so that it will be spacious. I'm also going to change the dynamic size jitter, so that will be, so there will be variation in size. If you want, you can also change the angle, but for now I'm not going to change the angle. I want straight pixels, but you can try it by changing the angle. Scatter, let me increase the scatter a little bit, and shape dynamics, yes, this looks good. So remember, if you apply black color on this particular layer mask, then this will be hidden, this layer will be hidden. So we are going to apply it. So we are basically seeing the background, which is white, like this. We are not applying white color, we are seeing the portion below this image, because we are deleting this by using the brush tool. And you can always change the brush size. So I want to show that these pixels are disintegrating and they are flying away, just like the Avengers movie when Thanos snaps his fingers. So disintegration. And now we are going to click on this middle layer and thumbnail of the layer mask, and we are going to use the white color because we want to make them visible, the pixels, like this. Again, change the size of the brush so that it will look disintegrated or different or scattered. So this is how it will look, and the quality of the end result depends upon your drawing ability, or how much quantity do you draw. So you can always change, if you want, the position of this particular, and press and hold shift button like this. So this is basically disintegrating. If you want some more, then again. And now I'm using a square brush because pixels are square, but you can always try with some other brush, like elliptical or the circular brush. So this is the technique. Using this technique, you can create some other effects. And if you want to add shadows to this layer, you can simply right click on it, go to blending options, and you can simply apply shadow, drop shadow to this image. And if you feel that this looks better without the shadow, you can simply turn the shadow off. So this is called as the disintegration effect or the dispersion effect, which is created by using the layer mask options. So please give it a go, try it out with different brushes. So that's it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Until then, bye bye and cheers.